guys, welcome to this video on adding and subtracting with exponents. To start off, just so that we're all on the same page, I'm going to define exponents as well as a few other things so that moving forward, hopefully, there won't be as much confusion. So, I'll start with the base, or base variable in this case. The base is the number that is being raised to the power of something, and that number that it's being raised to is called the exponent. What an exponent represents is how many times this base is being multiplied by itself. So in this case, x, our base, is being multiplied by itself twice. The number out in front of the variable is called the coefficient. Hopefully, now moving forward, you'll be able to better follow what I'm talking about as we reference these terms. Now, let's take a look at another problem. All right, so in order for us to simplify this, we have to look for two things. One, are our bases or variables the same? And two, are our exponents the same? Both things have to be true in order for us to add these two terms together. The same process of adding and subtracting with exponents is also called combining like terms, which may sound more familiar to you. Okay, so looking at our problem, we can see that our bases are the same, we have the same variable here, and our exponents are the same, which means we have two like terms that can be combined together. So to actually combine these terms, here's what you do. Add the coefficients together, but leave your base and exponents the exact same. In this problem, our coefficients are 5 and 9. And 5 plus 9, so we're leaving our base and exponent the same. So leaving our base and exponents alone, we get 14x to the third. Remember, to add or subtract numbers that have exponents, you must first make sure that the base and exponent of the two terms you're trying to add or subtract are the same. If they are the same, then all you have to do is add together the coefficients and keep the base and exponent the same. Let's take a look at another example. All right, so in this example, some of the terms have different exponents, so we need to identify all of our terms that can be combined together in order to simplify this expression. Starting with our 2x squared, are there any other terms with an identical base and exponent? Yes, our negative x squared. Our 5 is on its own, and negative 4x cubed plus 7x cubed share identical base and exponents. We know that to combine our like terms together, all we need to do is add together the coefficients of the corresponding like terms. So, here's how we can do that. Since we're adding together the coefficients of 2x squared and negative x squared together, and all other like terms, we can rewrite this expression to help us follow our work. Now, the reason that I brought my term with the 3 in the exponent to the front is because in the standard form of a polynomial equation, you always bring your term with the highest number in the exponent to the front, or to the left. Now, when we add our coefficients together, we get... At this point, all of our terms have been combined, and there's no further simplification that we can do, so we're done! I hope that this video was helpful, and for further help, be sure to check out more of our videos by subscribing to our channel below. See you next time.